Good morning, everyone. We're all here and ready to go. Good to see everybody. Here are a few of the opportunities this week coming up. Today at 6 p.m., a high school SWAT class will meet. And then Monday, we resume our Bible study on Zoom at 6. Tuesday, for all the school youth, grades 6 through 12, there's a See You at the Pole rally from 6:30 to 8 p.m. On the square, rain location here at FBC. If it's raining, be here at the church. Wednesday, Pastor Marty will be in his office. Wednesday evening, we have supper at 6 p.m., followed by our jam classes. And then Thursday, be sure to get your cookies for the first responders, which is due next Sunday for Faith in Action. And then on Friday is a unique sale, 9 a.m. to 6 p.m. at the Virden United Methodist Church. And it continues on Saturday from noon on. And then next Saturday, the Neighbors Black Powder Indian Summer Festival will begin, and it starts at 10 and goes to 4. And it's for kids. There's a touch a truck at Prairie Temple. Yeah, that's a separate thing. Yeah. And that's at noon to 3 o'clock. Next Sunday is our Faith in Action Sunday. If you haven't already signed up, please sign up today and get on the list that's back there as you go out the door. And so that we can plan better for our activities. Coming up, it's our church's turn for kindergarten snacks. It's the month of October, and proof snacks are on the bulletin board in Pittman Hall. And didn't we say if you needed somebody to buy the snacks? Okay, Jan's going this week to get those snacks, so if you can get your money into her, that'd be great. Any other announcements that need to be made today? Yes. Yes, we start Faith in Action at 9 a.m. Okay, so 9 a.m. here in the sanctuary is where we begin. We'll have communion, and then we'll divvy up in our different groups and go out. Pam, you had something? Okay, what will be held at Kyle and Pam Hawkins' house for any of those kids that want to come? Yes, Gloria. Okay, the kitchen group for Faith in Action will meet Saturday at what time again? 10 a.m. Okay, all right. Our birthdays and anniversaries today. Happy birthday to me, Mike Hawkins. Turned a big 73 for all of you who want to know and make fun. Or whatever. And then a happy birthday on Thursday to Ryan Birch, and happy birthday on Friday to Barb Lucky Taylor, and happy birthday on Saturday to Jennifer Brown and Justin Dibbler. Are there any other birthdays that anniversaries that were not mentioned? Our call to worship says from this person, "The function of prayer is not to influence God, but rather to change the nature of the one who prays." And shall we stand and sing hymn number 646, "Redeemed, How I Love to Proclaim It."
Redeemed, how I love to proclaim it. Redeemed by
Seated. Now is our time with Pastor Marty. So if our young people will come up front.
Morning. You guys had a good week? School going okay? You getting? I was going to ask if you're still getting too much homework. Oh, yeah. You want me to write a note to your teacher? Tell her to lay off the homework? She won't listen to me, I don't think. I don't think that'll work, but it's just a thought. But that. In spite of too much homework or other things maybe not going the way you'd like them to go, you know what? We can still be glad that God loves us, right? We still have parents who love us. We still have food to eat. We still have good things happening in our lives, even when everything's not going the way it should. But so the Bible says that we can rejoice in the Lord always. That means even on days when everything's not perfect, we can still rejoice in the Lord always. And there's a song that goes along with that verse of Scripture, rejoice in the Lord always, and again, I say rejoice. If you want to do a little bit of motion to the song, you can rejoice. When we sing rejoice, you can stand up, okay, and then sit down. Michael, you're looking sleepy. You with me? Okay. we'll do the motions. That way that'll help Michael wake up. You guys know the song, rejoice in the Lord always? And again, I say rejoice. Have you ever sung it before? Okay, well, I'll teach it to you. It's an easy song because that's about the only words to the whole song, but it's a good song. It goes like this. Rejoice in the Lord always. And again, I say rejoice. Rejoice in the Lord always. And again, I say rejoice. Rejoice, rejoice, and again I say rejoice. Rejoice, rejoice, and again I say rejoice. Rejoice in the Lord always, and again I say rejoice. Rejoice in the Lord always, and again I say rejoice. Rejoice, rejoice, and again I say rejoice. Rejoice, rejoice, and again I say rejoice. Rejoice in the Lord always, and again I say rejoice. Rejoice in the Lord always, and again I say rejoice. This is another song. Kind of goes along with the same chords. Different words, and it says, this is the day, this is the day that the Lord has made, that the Lord has made. We will rejoice, we will rejoice, and be glad in it, and be glad in it. This is the day that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. This is the day, this is the day that the Lord has made. Rejoice in the Lord always, and always remember this is the day. Every day is the day that the Lord has made, so we can always rejoice and be glad, okay? Let you guys go to children's church, all right?
All right, let's prepare ourselves for our tithes and our offerings. Heavenly Father, we dedicate these tithes and offerings to you giving through our hearts. And Lord, may we even give through our, not only our hearts, but with our money and our time and our attention to you and serving you, Lord. Lord, just ask you to bless this money to your purposes, to help those who are in need and to spread the gospel word. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Remain standing and let's sing a song of praise, Here I Am, Lord. Go to the Lord in prayer. Heavenly Father, we come to you with these concerns for health, for the baby Bennett, for our church members, Steve and people in our community, Lord, that are dear to us and loved ones. That are having going through struggles at this time, help us to come alongside and love on them and to lift them up with an encouragement, Lord. Lord, we just thank you that we can come here and praise you and lift you up. Lord, thank you for having mercy on each of us because of our sinful ways. Lord, we know we're not perfect, but we want to think of ourselves as that a lot of times, that we're okay. But you know our true hearts and our and where we're really at with you. Lord, just help us to know you and by praying to you and through reading your words of in the Bible to help us to see ourselves and see where our lives are with you. We thank you for loving us so much and for caring for us and having a plan. And in spite of our ways, Lord, you just love us to death. We are your children. And no matter what, you are our Father. And we thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Okay, I think it's time for Pastor Marty. Thank you.
The podium mic, okay. I didn't mean to make such fun of you on your birthday, okay. I'm sorry, 73. I'm not too far behind, and so hope everyone's doing all right this morning, and nice to have Libby's family with us, and welcome you, and everyone else looks like they're fairly regular here, so I won't say any more about that, but I'm going to use 1 Thessalonians 5:1-11 as my text this morning, and I'll read that text for you first, but I was thinking about my last message, and the thought came to me, and maybe it was the Holy Spirit, and I thought to myself, you know, I need to offer maybe less information and a little more inspiration. And so I apologize if I sometimes have offer too much information, but not enough to inspire you to do something with that information. So just a simple goal I have this morning is to encourage you. And so I'm offering just some encouraging words this morning. But I like this text from Paul's first letter to the Thessalonians, chapter 5, and I'll read verses 1 to 11, and then we'll talk about that passage a little bit. But here's what Paul has to say, and I think this is an interesting letter that he writes because we, I think, can identify with it. He says, "But as to the times and the seasons, brethren, you have no need to have anything written to you, for you yourselves know well that the day of the Lord will come like a thief in the night. When people say there is peace and security, then sudden destruction will come upon them as travail comes upon a woman with child, and there will be no escape. But you are not in darkness, brethren, for that day to surprise you like a thief. For you are all sons of light and sons of the day. We are not of the night or of darkness. So then let us not sleep as others do, but let us keep awake and be sober. For those who sleep, sleep at night, and those who get drunk are drunk at night. But since we belong to the day, let us be sober and put on the breastplate of faith and love, and for a helmet, the hope of salvation. For God has not destined us for wrath, but to obtain salvation through our Lord Jesus Christ, who died for us so that whether we wake or sleep, we might live with him. Therefore, encourage one another and build one another up just as you are doing." Therefore, encourage one another and build one another up just as you are doing. Paul says in his letter to the Romans, chapter 15, verse 4, that whatever was written in former days was written for our instruction, that by steadfastness and by the encouragement of the Scriptures, we might have hope. And here in our text from 1 Thessalonians, we're instructed to encourage one another and to build each other up just as you are doing, Paul says. And that's the way I feel about our congregation here, that we are a congregation that encourages one another and that we really seek to build each other up and to be there for each other beyond just getting together on a Sunday morning and singing some songs and reading some scripture, but that we really do seek to build one another up. Next Sunday, for Faith in Action, we're going to have the opportunity not just to build each other up here at the church, but to also step out of the church building and be a blessing to people in the community and to be an encouragement to them and even people in Springfield as we bring some food and things for them. And so I'm grateful. We talked about it a little bit in Sunday school this morning, but we have the blessing, I think, of being able to spend time focusing on our faith, on the salvation and the eternal life that we have through Jesus Christ and by putting our faith and trust in Him. But also, we have the opportunities daily to step out of that world of the afterlife and the abundant life we have by our own relationship with Christ, and to go out and to help people that are really not enjoying eternal life or abundant life, or in some cases, much of a life at all. And so I really look forward to the opportunity to be an encouragement to the people that God calls us to love and serve in the name of His Son, Jesus. I want you to be encouraged by knowing that God loves you. I think we sometimes take that for granted, or we use that phrase glibly, you know, smile, God loves you, or we kind of throw around these Christian phrases, but I think it's important for us to truly grasp what it means that God loves us. God loves you, I love you, and I feel your love reciprocated. That's the blessing that we have because we have the Spirit of Christ, the Spirit of love in our hearts and in our lives. God wants us to be in this faith, in this life of faith, not just for ourselves, but for one another in the body of Christ and for those outside that he loves and longs for and wants to redeem. God wants us to be engaged in this world that we live in, but not to be overwhelmed by the sadness in it, the evil in it, the disappointments, the frustrations. We can be in the world, but not of it. We don't have to buy into the hopelessness of the world because of the hope we have through our faith in Jesus Christ. And that's one of the greatest gifts we can offer people, is the hope that we have in our Lord Jesus Christ. It is by the encouragement of the Scriptures that we can find hope for living in this present world. The words of Scripture in our text here in 1 Thessalonians are as fitting for us as they were for the Thessalonians. We're aware of the times that we live in. Paul says, as to the times and the seasons, brethren, you have no need that anything be written to you. We're aware that we live in some interesting times, and we don't know what's around the corner, but we know we're living in times of great change, and maybe every generation has been able to say that because life has continued to change. You look at history, things happen that have never happened before. Life goes on, people pick up and move on, but there's always another change around the corner. And we're living in times now where change is happening so fast that 73-year-old guys like Mike and nearly 70-year-olds like me, it's harder to play catch-up with the world we live in and to make the adjustments that we need to make in order to get by. I was reading this morning about the changes in how money is being used, that we may be losing currency before long, and everything's going to be online or through computers, through chips, and through, and I think about, you know, it frightens me when I think about the book of Revelation talking about the mark of the beast, people not being able to buy or sell unless they have that mark. I remember when I was a young Christian thinking, well, that's kind of crazy sounding, and now it's like, this is just like probably around the corner, and I don't want us to find ourselves caught unawares when these things happen, these changes happen. We are not in control of what's happening in the world, but God is in charge. God is, He's the Creator. Jesus is Lord. And if we continue to put our faith and trust in Him, we don't have to live in fear about what changes are happening in our world, in our culture. But it is sobering when you read things that are kind of in the works these days. But I want you to be encouraged. I want you to know that God has you in the palm of His hand, and the Lord Jesus Christ has us in His church and His redeemed community. The change from the world's false sense of security to sudden destruction that Paul talks about. He says, You yourselves know well that the day of the Lord will come like a thief in the night. I remember there was a, did anybody see the movie Thief in the Night? It was a Christian film. Not very well done, but it was one of those early Jesus films. Trying to, and I always kind of didn't care for movies or things that tried to scare people into believing in Jesus, you know, or frightening people out of their wits. But Paul does talk about the day of the Lord. The day of the Lord is coming. The Lord is. We continue to talk about the second coming of Christ, but in fact, the second coming of Christ is one day closer every day that we live. Jesus is going to return. If you take the Bible seriously, if you take Jesus at his word, he said, I will return. In fact, he said to the disciples, don't let your hearts be troubled. Don't be consumed with worry and fear. You believe in God? Jesus said, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it wasn't so, I would tell you. And I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place, I will come back and receive you to myself so that where I am, there you may be also. So we need to have that promise always in the back of our minds and in our hearts, even as we face life from day to day. Now, I'm trying to encourage you. I don't want to talk too much about the darkness, the dark things of the world. We're not in the dark. As Paul says, because God has called us out of darkness into his marvelous light in Jesus, his beloved Son. By grace through faith in Jesus, we are sons and daughters of the light and of the day, not of the night nor of darkness, Paul says. That's the promise of God from his word. So Paul encourages the Thessalonians and us as well as we read these scriptures not to fall asleep at the wheel, as the expression goes. Stay awake to what God is doing. We can look at the news, we can see terrible things happening, but if we only look at the news and never look at the Word of God, we only know what the world is doing. We don't know what God is necessarily accomplishing in spite of what's happening in the world around us. So we need to be sober and serious about the things of God and the kingdom of God. Listen again to what Paul says in verse 8. But since we belong to the day, let us be sober and put on the breastplate of faith and love, and for a helmet, the hope of salvation. The breastplate of faith and love to guard our hearts. The hope of our salvation as a helmet to protect our minds. Faith, hope, and love. Where do these words show up again? 1 Corinthians 13, Paul writes, now we see in the mirror dimly, but then face to face. Now I know in part, then I shall understand fully, even as I have been fully understood. And then he says, so faith, hope, and love abide these three, but the greatest of these is love. The better we know the word of God, the better off we'll be. We've been destined, you and I, because we have been called to faith in Jesus Christ. Jesus said, you did not choose me, I chose you. We are believers in Christ because God has chosen us to believe and has given us the faith to put our trust in Jesus Christ. We've been destined not for wrath, but instead we've been destined to obtain salvation through our Lord Jesus Christ, the same incarnate Son of God who died for us so that our sins could be forgiven, and who rose from the dead for us so that we can live with him forever when he returns for us. And it's with this awareness, I believe, that we can and should continue to encourage one another. Now, I'm going to finish up this a little bit. There's another part of this fifth chapter of Thessalonians. Let me read for you these verses. This is you can follow along in your Bibles if you like, but 1 Thessalonians 5, verses 16 to 24, and I referred to this with the kids. We sang that song, Rejoice in the Lord Always, and again I say rejoice. Here's how Paul brings his letter to the Thessalonians to a conclusion. He says, rejoice always, pray constantly, give thanks in all circumstances, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus for you. Do not quench the Spirit. Do not despise prophesying, but test everything. Hold fast to what is good. Abstain from every form of evil. May the God of peace himself sanctify you wholly, and may your spirit and soul and body be kept sound and blameless at the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. He who calls you is faithful, and he will do it. He who calls you is faithful, and he will do it. Or as he says to the Philippians, he says, the good work that God has begun in you, he will bring it to completion in the day of Jesus Christ. That's Philippians 1, chapter 6, or chapter 1, verse 6. So I want you to be encouraged because you are in God's love, you are in his care. That breastplate of faith and hope will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. And the love of God, the peace of God, which passes all understanding, will keep your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus, our Savior and our Lord. In closing, let's stand and sing hymn number 432, Softly and Tenderly. I had the privilege yesterday morning of playing and singing this song at the funeral of Elizabeth Whittler, a dear friend and woman of God who lived 97 beautiful years on earth and passed away in her own home, still driving her own car, still living at home, 97. And her funeral was just a beautiful service yesterday because it was beautiful because everyone knew where she went after she left this earth. She went to be with her Lord and Savior, who is also our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. And so let's sing that song softly and tenderly. Father in heaven, we thank you for calling us to faith in your Son, Jesus. And Lord, we don't want to live our lives in fear, but we want to live them trusting in you, believing in your Son, Jesus, and having the assurance of your love and your care for us, the assurance of our salvation by grace through faith in Jesus. And Lord, I pray that you will just encourage our hearts. Lord, knit us together in the love of your Holy Spirit, in the grace of Jesus, your Son. Just give us the faith to trust in you as times become challenging for us, as the things that we face in this world can sometimes overwhelm us. I pray that you would just continue to grant us that encouragement for our hearts. May we be able to wear each day the breastplate of faith and love, and for our hope, the helmet of salvation. For we ask these things in Jesus our Lord. Amen. Well, God bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up his countenance and give you peace and joy today and every day and bring us back safely together in the days to come. Amen.